loud. Get the sound here turned down a bit. I'm sorry about that. Back a little. Gonna do a quick sound check. Okay, great. Thanks. So, hi, my name is Alice Steinglass. I work on the user experience for Windows 8, and I'm excited to be here today to show you a little preview of what we're building with the next version of Windows. With Windows 8, we've really reimagined Windows, from the chipset up to the user experience. We're combining the power of your PC with the potential of your tablet into one no-compromise experience. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you what this feels like on a couple of different form factors. I'm going to start off by showing you what it feels like on a tablet. We're going to show you how fast and fluid it is to use Windows with touch. Next, I'm going to move over to a normal laptop, no touch, mouse and keyboard. I'm going to show you the power and efficiency you can have with a mouse and keyboard on Windows 8. And then we're going to move over to another tablet. I'm going to show you a couple new features there. So to begin with, we're going to start on this tablet. This is the one we gave away at the Build conference in September. It has the developer preview release of Windows. We've already had over 3 million people download the developer preview release of Windows. That's an incredible amount of developer momentum around this. I'm going to show you how it feels with touch to users, how fast and fluid and native it feels with your finger. And this starts right from the moment I unlock the screen to log on. I just go ahead and swipe up. And I'm going to use a picture password to log on. You can take any picture you want. This is a picture of my son, Owen. And I'm going to draw a pattern on it. So this is a secure, fun, and reliable way to just get into your PC with touch. Now, when I open my PC, the first thing I'm going to see is my new start screen. Your start screen is filled with the things you care about. It has your apps, the websites you care about, the content you care about. And it's more than just icons. These tiles are alive with activity. They're connected to my services, to my friends, to the things I care about. So I don't even have to launch the apps to be able to tell what my most recent email is here from Anshul, or my next headline coming from my RSS feeder. I'm just connected to all of these services from the instant I open the PC. And it's fast and fluid to pan through this experience and look at all of my apps. Now, to make it easier to follow this demo, I've turned on touch visualizations. So you see that dot on the screen? Anywhere you see that dot, that's where my finger is. And as you can see, it sticks right to the screen as I pan. So you have excellent stick-to-your-finger performance as I slide through my start screen. Now, I'm going to go ahead and launch an app. This is Cut the Rope. You guys have probably seen this before. If you haven't, it's a fun, cute game that's available for a number of platforms. What I want to point out here is not what you can see, but what you can't see. This is built on our new developer platform for Windows 8. And that developer platform allows developers to leverage the tools they know today to quickly get up and running with a Windows 8 app. The Zepto Labs team that built this actually built it for HTML5 first. And then with the new developer platform, it supports the languages CSS, HTML, JavaScript that you use natively on the web. So it's easy for them to bring that app over and have it running here on Windows 8. The other thing that you may not notice here, because it's not on the screen, are all our buttons and controls. With Windows 8, the new Metro-style apps are immersive, full screen. Every pixel on the screen is dedicated to your content. And we've removed all of the glass borders and controls and buttons to get them out of your way so you can focus on what you care about. But when you do need the Windows controls, they're just a swipe away. What I'm going to do is just swipe in from the right edge of the screen to bring up my Windows charms. These are available everywhere in every app you're in. And they allow you to connect your app to other apps, to devices, to the people you care about. Everywhere you are, you can always get to search, share, start, devices, and settings. I'm going to show you a little bit more about those later, but right now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to start to look again at my start screen and my apps. As you can see, I've got a ton of apps here, but sometimes the app I want is not on my screen. And with Windows 8, we've implemented an app store that makes it seamless for users to go in and get new apps for their PC. This also creates a great opportunity for developers to sell their apps directly to users. And with 1.25 billion PCs out there, and an estimated 400 million PCs shipping over the next 12 months, this is really the most significant developer opportunity ever. And as you can see, we've made it seamless for users to go through, browse different categories of apps, come in, look at an app, either try it or buy it, look at the reviews on it, and it's all one seamless experience with Windows 8. But I know some of you are out there are looking at this and saying, that's great. If I have a touch tablet, that sounds like a lot of fun. But I've got a desktop at home. I've got a laptop and it doesn't have touch. How am I going to use Windows 8? How is it going to feel for me? So what I'm going to do now is I'm switching over over to this laptop here. This is a regular laptop. You can buy it today off the shelf. And what I've done is I've installed Windows 8 on it. There's no touch on this screen. And I'm going to show you how efficient and powerful you can be with a mouse and keyboard on Windows 8. Now, the first thing you're going to see on this PC is that I've customized it slightly differently. I've got a different background on my lock screen. I've gone ahead and picked some apps I cared about and let them send notifications directly to the start screen. So I decided that I want to be able to see how many emails I want. I can put that right here. I can pull in my calendar appointment and look at all of that without even logging into my PC. When I do want to log in, because I'm using a keyboard and mouse, instead of swiping up, I'm just going to hit enter to log in. Instead of using my picture password, I'm just going to type my password. And once again, I'm at my start screen, filled with my apps, live with activity, connected to the things I care about. Before I showed you how I could easily glide through MoGo, glide through the start screen back and forth by using my finger. Now I'm going to show you how fast and efficient that is with a mouse. So here with my mouse, of course I can use the scroll wheel, page up, page down, use the scroll bar to go back and forth, but we wanted to make it even easier. So I can take my mouse, and without pushing any buttons, I can just go ahead and push it against the edge of the screen, and as I do that, I glide seamlessly through the start screen without pushing anything. And that feels great, but we wanted to make it even more efficient. So with Windows 8, we've also added the ability, we've also added the ability to be able to look through all of your apps, to be able to find the app you want here, and to be able with the mouse or the keyboard to zoom directly out and at a glance be able to see all of the different groups of your apps. You can group them how you want, you can name them or not name them, you can organize them in the way that you want. And what this allows me to do is just with a single click, drill in directly to the group I want to go to so that I don't have to glide, I don't have to look through my start screen, I can instantly zoom out and zoom in. This makes me super efficient with the mouse or keyboard. Now, Zoom feels great for being able to navigate to the app I want, but Zoom is also excellent when it comes to finding a way to move your apps around quickly over the space. So for example, let's go to this eBay app here. I can go and take it and move it around just like you'd expect, drag it across to different screens. But with my mouse, what I can do is just drag it right to the bottom of the screen and then move it all the way from the first group to the last group in one smooth movement. This is just a couple of the things that we've done to really make you powerful and efficient with your mouse. Now I want to show you a little bit about what we've done to make the keyboard just as efficient. One question that we get is, that's great, I saw some Metro apps here, but I don't just use Metro apps. I use my PC for all sorts of things. I use Excel a lot. How do I use that on my Windows 8 PC? Well, your Windows 8 PC is backward compatible with all the apps you use today on Windows 7. They live here right alongside your Metro apps and your start screen. I can go ahead and launch Excel just by clicking it right here, and it'll run just the same way it runs on Windows 7 today. But for those of you who are keyboard enthusiasts like me, I'm going to show you another way I can launch my app. And that's through keyboard, and that's by using search and typing. So, just like on Windows 7, in my start menu, I don't have to touch my mouse. My hands don't have to leave my keyboard. I don't have to hit any search boxes. I don't have to click on anything. I can just, once I'm in the start screen, I can just start typing. E, X, C. We're going to auto-filter through the apps on your PC. I hit enter, and without my hands leaving the keyboard, I'm right here in Excel. That's just some of the power and efficiency you get by adding a keyboard to the potential that you have with your tablet. And what you're looking at here really is Excel. As you can see, it runs just the way it runs in Windows 7. I can do all the things in it that I'd love to do in Windows 7. I can take Excel, I can snap it to the side of the screen, I can maximize it, I can bring it down. I have my taskbar here, I can use it to switch to my other desktop apps. I can pin apps and launch apps from my taskbar. So for example, we can launch PowerPoint here. I can switch back and forth between them. Everything you'd expect to be able to do on your PC. But with Windows 8, you can do more than that. You can use these desktop apps right alongside the new Metro-style immersive apps I showed you before. So going back to start here, and I'm going to go launch my video. And what you see here is a beautiful full-screen HD immersive 16:9 video playing on the screen. It's my new Metro-style video player. And when I want to switch back to my Excel spreadsheet, I can just click in the corner, or again, because we're showing off the keyboard shortcuts, I'm going to show you another one of my favorite ones from Windows 7, which is Alt-Tab. Of course, all your keyboard shortcuts keep working, so I can just Alt-Tab right back to PowerPoint. I'll tab back to my video. I'll tab back to PowerPoint and instantly switch back and forth seamlessly between my immersive environment and the desktop environment you know today. And I can use both alongside each other. So we can go grab that video and I can snap it on the side of the screen. I can even snap it on the other side of the screen. And what I've got now is I can keep an eye on that video while I use my desktop apps. So if this is the soccer game and I don't want to miss a score, I want to keep an eye on it and make sure I don't miss any of the action, it stays right there. And even as I move those apps around, as I maximize them, as I switch them, I don't have to worry about them potentially overlapping the video. The video keeps playing right here on the side while I continue to work on my desktop over here. And when I'm done with it, it's simple for me to just slide it off the screen and again focus back on my desktop. So what you're seeing here is the ability, really, on your Windows 8 PC to combine all of the power of your PC and the way you use it today with these new Metro-style apps, and to do it efficiently and effectively with the mouse and the keyboard. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move over to another tablet here. And for those of you who've been using the developer preview build, this is a more recent build of Windows, so you might see some features here that aren't on the build that you're using. And what I want to show you here is how we will, is some of the features that we have that allow apps to connect to each other to create new experiences in Windows 8. And that starts with the Windows Charms. At any point in any app in the system, you can go ahead and swipe it from the right to bring up the Windows Charms. Search, Share, Start, Devices, and Settings. And I'm going to start here with the Settings Charm. Before I showed you how I could organize some of the apps in my Start screen, I could do even more to change some of the settings in my Start screen and in the system. And from any app at any point, you can always go to Settings and get links to the settings for that app, as well as the common settings you need across the system, like being able to turn off notifications or change your volume. And right now I'm going to drill into some more PC settings. And I'm not going to walk you guys through all the settings on the PC right now, but for those of you who have been playing with the developer preview build, you'll probably be glad to see that in the next version you'll be able to change the background pattern and color on your Start screen. But right now what I want to do is I want to go in and look at changing my account picture. What I've brought up here is a new touchable file picker for Windows 8. This allows me to pick files in an easy, fluid way from my file system. I can browse it, I can go through it. And when I say file system, I really mean file system. This is your PC. This is not some device that connects with your PC where you have to stream the data from the server or from another device. All your files can be here. This is your PC and it has all the power of your PC. And that includes full access to your file system. I've got my documents here. I've got my pictures, my videos, my music. I've got access to my C colon drive and my D colon drive. And it's all here, right here, accessible via touch on my tablet PC. But some of my photos aren't on my hard drive. They're not on my network or my home group. Some of my files are on Facebook or they're on Flickr. I uploaded them there. A friend uploaded them there. And with Windows 8, it's just as easy to get to things that are on services or in apps as it is to get to the things on your local hard drive. Any app can go ahead and expose that data right here in my file picker alongside the native Windows locations. So for example, I've got this photo feeder app. This is just a sample app that a guy on our team wrote. And what he did was he uploaded a bunch of pictures from some people on our team to PhotoFeeder. And here, I can tap that and see the photos that we have on PhotoFeeder. I can choose my photo to choose that image. And as you can see, it was just as easy for me to pick a photo from PhotoFeeder as it was to pick a photo from my local hard drive. Just the same way I store my data in all these different locations, I want to be able to search across these locations. So again, from any app in Windows, I can always get to this search charm. And I'm going to go ahead and search for my friend Jason. I'm going to search on this Socialite app. This is another little sample app that someone on our team wrote. And what it does is it hits the Facebook backend. So when I search through Socialite, I'm able to search Facebook so I can see Jason's wall and all of the information about Jason. And sometimes when I search, I want to see all about Jason. On Facebook, but sometimes I want to search my email, and sometimes I want to search the web, and sometimes I want to search the hard drive. And with Windows 8, we have a pluggable interface that allows you seamlessly to get across the locations on your PC or in any of your services or apps that have searchable data. So I can instantly go and look at files of Jason, pictures of Jason on my local file hard drive. Or I can go search the general web, and let's see what Bing has to say about Jason. And all of that that is just one seamless experience with search in Windows 8. Now I want to take a moment here and take a look at what we're looking at. This is the new Metro style browser for Windows 8. Just like the other Metro style apps I showed you, it's full screen and immersive. So every pixel on the screen is dedicated to my content. I can see my website with every pixel on the screen. I'm really focused on what I care about. I'm not worried about the Chrome and the buttons. That's not what I care about. When I'm browsing the web, I want to see the web. But when I do need the commands, they're just a swipe away. I can swipe in from the right edge of the screen, as I showed you before, to get the Windows commands, or I can swipe in from the top or bottom of the screen and bring up the app commands. And this is a common gesture you can use across your Metro applications. Here I've got my tab switcher and a URL bar and some commands for Internet Explorer. I'm going to go ahead and switch tabs here. And what you're going to see as I pan this is that we have smooth padding, excellent performance, the fonts are rendered beautifully as I zoom in. This is because the new Metro-style browser is built on the same underlying engine that powers IE10, which means you have hardware acceleration, fantastic performance, security and privacy features that you know in IE10 are all available as part of the Metro-style browser. But what we wanted to do was also add to that and make a really touch-first experience with how you would use it. So as I navigate, let's go to this other side, Tales from a Cook. As I navigate through the web, of course I can hit the back button here, but with touch we wanted to make it even more fluid. So I can just swipe back to go to the page I was last at, swipe forward, come back here, and it's effortless to browse through the internet with touch using the Metro-style Internet Explorer. Now there's one more charm I want to show here, so let's go over to another page. And here I've got a video. This is the same video we showed during the keynote. And what you see here is that this video is playing directly in my app, sorry, in the browser, with no plugins required. That's because it's running using HTML5, and IE is committed to rich HTML5 standard support across IE and across our Metro-style browser. Now, one of the things that you see in the web a lot today is share. You can share to a whole bunch of different apps. Every app developer, every website developer has to go ahead and choose the different apps that you can share with from their site. They have to implement the contracts that allow them to share with all those different places. And you as a user have to figure out on any different site, can I share with this, can I share with that, how do I get my data from this to my note-taking app? It may or may not support it. With Windows 8, we've tried to make it easy for developers and a consistent great experience for users. So for developers, all you have to do is say you have content to share. You could have a video to share, you could have text to share, you could have a URL. And it's up to them to just say, hey, this is content I want to share, and then the user can go ahead and share that content in one consistent place. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select this text up here about Steve Ballmer. I'm going to grab it, and I'm going to bring up the share charm. And because we have one consistent place, it makes it easy for me to find share. And actually, you know, I'm going to share a whole screenshot of IE here. And what it does is it brings up all the apps on my system that know how to take that screenshot and share it. So I can share it to FriendSend, I can share it to my mail app, I've got a note app here, a note-taking app. And as I get more apps for Windows 8, each of those apps can come in and show me different places and locations that I can share with. Right now I'm going to send this picture to my friend Katie. I'm going to type a little message to her, and I'm going to deliberately misspell this message. And what you'll see as I do this is that Windows will automatically correct it. We've got automatic spell checking built into our new touch keyboard across all of your Metro-style apps. And if I'm using a regular keyboard, I get regular spell checking with the little red squiggles anywhere I am in any Metro-style app and across the browser as part of Windows 8. This isn't something app developers have to do, they just get this for free. We've also tried to make our touch keyboard really ergonomic. So here, if I'm typing like in a demo, and I'm just using my hands on the keyboard, I can go ahead and type the way you're seeing it here. But sometimes I'm holding my keyboard with my thumbs, and I want to be able to easily type with my thumbs on my keyboard. We've made that easy too with Windows 8. I can just switch over to this thumbs keyboard. I can even size it to fit my thumbs. So Steve was doing the last demo, and his hands are a little bigger than mine. So I'm going to go ahead and make it a little smaller so it really fits me. It's customized for me. I'm going to go ahead and go back and share this picture. And what you'll see is I'm able to share that picture without leaving the context of the app I'm in. So I don't need to go switch apps, I don't need to go take my content and save it somewhere and bring it back in another app. I can stay right where I am and go share my content with any app that I want to share it with. Now that was fun. fun. We saw a bunch of different apps. We looked at how it worked with touch, keyboard, mouse. But if you're like me, you're wondering what the performance impact of all this is. You know, we're here at CES. We're all a little geeky. We want to see what's going on under the hood. So let's go check that out right now. To make it a little bit more fun, let's launch a few more apps before we do that. Here, I've got my weather app. I don't actually need to launch my weather app because my live tile tells me the weather right there. But let's launch it anyway. I'm going to go launch this RSS reader here that shows me some news. We can launch the stocks app so we can take a look at some stocks. So I've got a bunch of these metro apps running right now. And what I'm going to go do is I'm going to launch the task manager. Now, this isn't something you need to launch. This isn't something that that's part of using your PC, but it's for, you know, if you want to find out what's going on under the hood, we've made it even more powerful in the next version of Windows 8. You've got a heat map here, I've got a bunch of different tabs here which shows me things like my app history. I'm not going to dig into all of that right now, but what I do want to call your attention to is one of these apps that we just launched, this news app, and what you'll see is that it's using 0% of the CPU. That's because Windows is going to automatically suspend my apps for me when I'm not using them. This means that they're not using any of my CPU, they're not impacting my performance, and they're not draining my battery. What that means for me is that I can launch Metro app after Metro style app after Metro style app and not worry about draining the battery life on my PC. I don't need to close my apps because Windows is going to manage that process for me. So that's why there's no red X on the corner of your Windows, of your new Metro style app. It's just not something you need to worry about. That said, sometimes you want to close something anyway, and we wanted to make that just as fast and fluid with Windows 8 as all of the other features I was showing you. So let's go back to those Metro style apps I just launched. And one of the things we've done with Windows 8 is make it easy to get back to the last app you were using. Just as I can swipe in from the right side of the screen to bring in my charms, I can swipe in from the left side of the screen at any point to go back to the last app I was using. This makes it fluid for me to go back to the stocks app, or the news app, or the weather app. And just as I showed you before, I can even snap two apps right next to each other, so I can multitask on my screen. Now let's say we're done with this weather app. It's 57 degrees out, but we're all stuck inside it all day anyway, so it doesn't really matter and I don't want to look at it. Again, I don't need to close it because Windows will manage the performance for me, but if I do want to get rid of it, I just swipe from the top of the screen right down to the bottom of the screen and throw it off the bottom of the screen, and it's gone. I can even close an app that I'm not currently using. As I'm swiping through my apps, I'm looking at them. If I don't want to see the stocks app anymore, I can just grab it, swipe it right off the bottom of the screen to get rid of it. Or if I want to do my current app, I don't want to have to go somewhere else to close the app I'm currently using. I just grab the app I'm using, swipe it right off the bottom of the screen, and it's gone. Now this is just a little preview of some of the things that are coming in the next version of Windows 8. We're really excited about what we're doing here. We're trying to really reimagine Windows from the chipset all the way up to the user experience. We're combining the power of your PC with the potential of your tablet into one no-compromise solution, which works great whether you're using it with your touch or with the mouse or with the keyboard. You have the power of all of the different input methods that you can use simultaneously in one OS. My name is Alice. I'm going to be up here for a little longer to answer some questions for the next 5 minutes. And then we've got another demo coming on that will start at 3:30. So if you came in late and you missed the beginning of the demo, stick around and you can see us demo it again. Thanks.
I showed a little bit of it. I showed the, come over here. So here when I showed you settings, this is the new touchable version where I can see all the different, you know, settings that I can set on the PC. And of course I can still get to all of the classic control panel settings, and those look exactly the same.